Our cost of living crisis and a possible economic recession doesn't seem to have scared off home buyers across Australia. Instead, new data shows we could be heading for a new high in the housing market. For more, I'm joined by PropTrack senior economist Eleanor Cray. Eleanor, what is driving these rising house prices?
Thank you for having me. It's certainly interesting at the moment, and we have seen that national house prices have recorded their fifth consecutive month of growth in May, rising a further 0.33%. Now, that brings national home prices up 1.55% from their low point in December 2022. And there are a number of factors that are contributing to this rise in home prices. We've seen that the housing market has so far started 2023 on a stronger footing, and we've got a stronger housing demand environment, likely bolstered by that very strong rebound in net overseas migration and what are, as we all know, very tight rental markets in most capital cities across the country. Now, given that we're continuing to see the flow of new listings coming to market is pretty soft, and we've got a pretty tight supply environment, that's working to concentrate buyer interest and really underpinning home prices and very much offsetting the downward pressure from the continued interest rate rises we've seen so far this year.
So when could we see this current trend peak?
So if we were to see national home prices growing at the same pace as they have over the past quarter, which was actually the strongest quarterly pace of price growth since March 2022 when home prices peaked last year, we could see that national prices end the year up around 4% and take out their previous record high in March last year by January 2024.
Okay, we've just had another interest rate rise. A lot of economists saying we're going to have at least another one. What effect do you think the rising interest rates are having on the market?
Yeah, look, that's the key caveat, I'd say. That's if growth continues at this pace, and certainly there are a number of factors as to why it may not. And the outlook for home prices does still remain uncertain despite that 5 months of growth that we have seen so far this year. Now, we do know that interest rates rose further this week, and they are likely to continue to rise. So we're probably going to get at least one more rate rise, maybe in July or August, and that certainly could slow the pace of price growth and slow the recovery that we've seen in recent months, particularly with the seasonally quieter winter period coming up for the property market.
Indeed. Okay, PropTrack senior economist Eleanor Cray, thanks so much for your time.
Thank you for having me.
There's a sharp warning for our economy this afternoon that we could be heading for a recession. Stubbornly high inflation and rising interest rates are eating into household savings. The result is an economy struggling to grow and a Reserve Bank on notice.
If they get two quarters of negative growth, they won't keep interest rates where they are. They'll know that inflation's on the way down.
It's not just Australia. Global growth is predicted to slow significantly this year on the back of the Ukraine war and banking stress in major economies. For more, Network Finance Editor Gemma Acton joins me. Now, Gem, it's a technicality, but what exactly is a recession?
And the definition of a recession is two quarters in a row of negative GDP growth or economic growth. Now, we saw from yesterday's numbers that as far as March, growth was still positive, but it might have actually declined since then, so we know that consumer spending has slowed down a lot.
So what impact will it have on everyday Australians?
We're not going to suddenly feel it if we go into a technical recession from one day to the next. It doesn't really make a difference to our everyday lives, and in fact, the data won't actually tell us until a couple of months later because it's always delayed. What does matter, though, is how the average Australian is feeling, and we know that many households are right now feeling under intense pressure. We've had a full 4% of rate hikes in just over 13 months, which is the most aggressive rate tightening cycle in a whole generation. When you combine that with really high inflation, we see that many households are having to make lifestyle adjustments, mostly cutting back on spending, particularly when it comes to optional extras like travel or dining out. What's really important to remember, though, Ange, is the very different experience that different households are having. If you own your home outright and you have some spare cash in a savings account, this might be quite a good time for you. If you have a very large mortgage or your rent's just gone up a lot, it could be a very, very challenging time indeed.
Okay, so we heard then that there are domestic issues and also global. What impacts our economy the most?
Yeah, it's a combination of the two. So global inflation soared during the pandemic when supply chains collapsed, and it stayed far higher for far longer than anybody was really expecting. And it is that inflation that has caused central banks around the world, including here at home, the Reserve Bank, to raise interest rates just so aggressively. But as you mentioned earlier, a lot of economies around the world are looking at a pretty patchy outlook right now, including the major economies of the US and China. If we see a drop in demand for exports, particularly for our commodities, that will really hurt our economy.
Okay, so how close right now are we, crystal ball it, to a recession?
Question, yeah. It depends on who you ask. If you look at what the financial markets are doing, they suggest that we are edging closer and closer towards a recession. If you ask the Commonwealth Bank economists, they're saying we could be in one by the end of this year. If you ask AMP, they're saying it's more likely to be next year.
Okay, Gemma, thanks so much as always.
Thank you. Insights.